Hello guys, this is Johnson Magone, and welcome back to this channel. Now this is my fifth day in Wisconsin. We have a lot of fun things to do. We're gonna go do some miniature golf, we're gonna do some bowling, we're gonna go to an escape room, which both of us have never done before, and I'm so excited for. And then probably gonna do some other things, but what I do know is we're gonna end the day watching the new Indiana Jones movie. So I'm finishing getting ready, and we'll be on the road. I'm so excited for this.
1 hour later.
Oh, V10's golf line. It's time to go play some golf. Oh, look at this place. This is awesome. Wow.
Whee!
There we go. Oh, I got myself a nice view from the lighthouse. It's the tallest one. You could see everything from down here. Found another slide. Whee! Ah, that's way too small. The golf course was amazing, it was beautiful, and it was so amazing there. Now at the miniature golf course, there's like three places. Like two of the courses are outside and one of them was inside. So we played outside. There were two courses. One is the Wisconsin course and the other is the California course. So we started off with the Wisconsin course. Like, I got lots of pars, I got some birdies, and all of that. I mean, like, Dad did okay, but there were so many moments where he was this close to the hole and it just missed. Like, either he went past by or it just went in and it's like, nope, it went out. But he was so close and he was way behind. Like. But in the end of the Wisconsin course, I won the Wisconsin course. Like, I straight up dominated and all of that. Now, interesting fact I like to point out, it's like, while Dan and I was playing in the Wisconsin course, a random kid came along and joined us to play and all of that. It's like, he was with us, he was playing, and we were having conversations, and somehow he did much better than the both of us combined and all that, which was really interesting. Like, why he decided to join us, I have no clue, but it was definitely interesting. So after that, we went to the California course. Okay, I'm in another high view, and I just got a hole-in-one. That's a first. Now it's time for me to go down the slide. Okay, we're upstairs again, and now it's time to go down the slide again. Come on. There we go.
Now the California course was interesting. It was interesting holes, and again, I got some pars, I got some birdies, but there was one point that I got a hole in one, which was really cool. Unfortunately, that course was much harder. It's like, there are a lot of courses that goes in the water, and there were a lot of holes that were just, I struggled way too much, including the final hole where it's even impossible to start because like you go in front and then there's this hill that goes around and you have to be perfect. Like, if you overdo it, it's going to bounce off that wall and either get out of bounds or put you right back where you started. If you undershot it, it's going to roll down back, starting all over again. Like, you have to be perfect. You have to make sure it goes around and the other side, which
sucks. Like, I did over 10 strokes. Like, I didn't have a good time there. So I struggled a lot, and in the end, I have no idea who won. Like, it's like, I don't know if Dad won or I somehow win based on the two of us, not the kid. Obviously, the kid probably did much better than the both of us, but regardless of that, we had so much fun. It's like as we were going to the California course, we went past his grandma, and his grandma was so happy that we allowed him to play with us and all that. And then while in the middle of the course, he had to leave early and all that. So his grandma came to pick him up, and when she came, she talked to Dad and I, and she was like, thank you so much. You're so nice. It's so nice you get to let him play with you. He's the only child. Thank you. I appreciate you guys. And it's definitely interesting right there. So after that, Dad and I got some ice cream once again from the chocolate ice cream shop. You know, the same ice cream place that we went to on Sunday. And ice cream, of course, was really good and everything. And then after that, we went to Escapeology. It's like, I knew about it, like, the day before, and I was like, Dad, we should go there. This is awesome.
Oh boy, time to go into the escape room, Escapeology. First ever escape room. So excited for this.
So we went inside and it was amazing and all that. Like, this is the first time that both Dad and I done an escape room. And it was really interesting. Like, if you guys have done the escape room before, or at least know about them, you already know what's up. But if you haven't done an escape room before, or have no idea what it is, I'll tell you the idea. The idea is that you're locked inside a room and you have a limited time to escape. Like, you have to work as a team, go around looking for clues in order to escape in a certain amount of time. It's like some clues are a bit obvious, but others you really need to focus on it in order to solve the clues and beat the game and all that. Now, the one that Dad and I did, the escape room we did, was the 7 Deadly Sins. So the backstory about this is that there was a minister in the late 19th century of Crickley Church that killed his entire congregation after the confessions convinced his twisted mind that they committed the 7 deadly sins. Like, in order to punish them for their sins, he passed around poisonous bread and wine. And as the congregation died, the minister himself incited a curse on the children playing in the rooms beneath the church, and then buried himself alive in the church's hidden crypt, determined to haunt the church forevermore. And apparently, our great-grandfather was one of those innocent children, and we began to think back on mysterious deaths of family members and close friends ever since the fateful night. So like, it's a very interesting concept. But the general thing that Dad and I needed to do was to find a hidden crypt, find the dagger, and drive it through the heart of the evil minister. And only then will we be saved and will destroy the curse, meaning we escape and all that. But now, what's interesting is that out of all the escape rooms in the Escapeology, 7 Deadly Sins is the hardest out of all of them. And that was really interesting, an interesting challenge. So Dad and I were locked in, we watched the video, which you can find on the Escapeology Escape Rooms YouTube channel. And we've told a video about the backstory and our mission, and we had a time limit of an hour to escape.
It's unfortunately I can't find the videos and everything about people doing that escape room, so it's gonna be hard to mention it. It's hard for me to keep track of everything, but Dan and I were just looking around, working together and everything. And then we found some skulls with the numbers, and then we put in codes, and we just like opened the door, and then we saw like some numbers, like maps and all that, and we saw a book. Someone assigns the youngest put the code oldest to youngest, and then for the numbers we saw, we put in the codes on the lock. It's a certain type of code, and all that. Luckily for us, we got the right one, and we found the dagger. So one of the three is done. Now all we needed to do was to find the hidden crypt, find the minister, and stab him in the heart with the dagger. But we keep looking around, and we're trying to figure it out. And then we saw this big machine thing with glass, and inside there were coins and all that, and there was a key there. So we found some poles nearby, and what we did, we needed to put it in holes and then pick a key up. But it's not easy enough. Like, not only you have to pick it up, but you gotta levitate your way to make sure and get it out. It's like we gotta pick it up, and then we gotta put the other hole, put it in another hole, and then you just pick that up, and then keep going and going until you're able to get through the hole to get the key out. And then we got the key, and we just unlocked the master, and it was the master key. Then we unlocked the lock in the big giant cabinet, and inside there was like some shovels and some holes, like you gotta figure out a lock of a certain code. And then, like, inside we found some wooden pieces with words, like a puzzle, a secret message. Like, we put them all together, but if it wasn't encrypted enough, like, there was some mystery, like we needed to do a certain amount of letters and make them into numbers and put them in codes. We pretty much found barely and all that, and then able to unlock, and we got the pole, and then there was the thing in front of us with the holes, so we had to put them in a certain amount of spot, like all in the same level. And then the orange tape around it, it pretty much has numbers nearby that we gotta use for codes and everything. But like, Dan and I were doing so well in the beginning. Of course there were times we struggled, and we had to use hints, which you can only do three, but if you have more than three hints, it's gonna decrease your time and all that. So pretty much you can escape, but depending on the time and amount of hints you use, you could still lose from that. So we struggled, we tried our best to figure it out and all that, but unfortunately we couldn't finish it off, and the time went out, and we lost. So after that, one of the workers came in and pretty much told us how much we had left to do. So it's like we used the zodiac codes, zodiac signs for coding and with the swing. And then there was something there to open a wall that leads us to the cryptic, and it shows the minister and have a staff. So we were very, very close. We just, like, if we knew about the later ones later on, but like the things we had left to do when we were told, I was like, I knew it, we should have done this. But we were that close. Like, considering it was our first escape room, we did very good, especially in the hardest map ever. So, like, I don't know if there's an escape room in New York, but if there is, I gotta try those out again that time. Like, we lost for now, but we probably made it much further than people like we are in our first try. and I'm at least happy about that, and we had so much fun. So after all of that, it was time to go to the movies to see Indiana Jones.
Okay, we finally made it to Marcus Point Cinema. Time to watch the new Indiana Jones movie.
Theater was nice and it was amazing. The food was delicious and everything. Now, interesting fact I like to point out, like, my grandma, my father's mother, actually works at the movie theater. Yes, she gets to work at a theater. It's like she's there, like, either snacks or talking or something like that. I don't remember 100% of the position she did. But what's interesting is that she gets a discount to family and friends and all that. It's like Dad and I got a discount from Grandma, which allows us to pay $1 for our tickets. So yeah, instead of paying like several dollars for our tickets, we actually paid $1 for our own tickets. So $2 to get both of our tickets, which is a really big deal. Now, of course, I would have wished we got it for free, but a discount is fine and all that. So now, we came back after seeing Indiana Jones. Now, I did record an outro for it when we got back, but unfortunately my storage was too full that I had to delete it. So this is how this is gonna end here. It's like, we watched it, and it was so good. It's like we had a fun time watching Indiana Jones. It was amazing and a perfect way to end the series and all that, which I wish wasn't. I wish there was more, but it was so good and we enjoyed it. Like, we had so much fun that day and I'm so glad we were able to do it. So of course, in the next video, I'll be talking about what we did on Thursday, which is talking about the county fair. Stay tuned for that, because it's interesting and really fun, and I know you'll enjoy that. But either way, that is all on my fifth day of Wisconsin on Wednesday, July 19th. I hope you enjoy this video, and I hope you enjoy knowing all of those. Like seriously, if you haven't done so, please try an escape room. Like, it's really fun, and I know it's worth it. Either way, I hope you enjoyed this video. And with that said, this has been Justin McGolan. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thank you, and God bless America.